Hey, what's up everyone, welcome to Profit Data. Today exactly I'm gonna talk about this automating your trades in exactly cloud. Okay, so I am here with this Python Anywhere. Exactly in this Python Anywhere you will get a free account. Okay, if you get to this one account or this one, exactly you get to know that this is my free account, and I am using this for purpose of testing my so I am exactly using this beginner free account. Okay, so with the help of this exactly I can develop some of this code of stuff or something, which exactly I can automate my trade. Simple strategies exactly can automate. Okay, so this is exactly a beginner account, you no need to pay anything for this one. Okay, plus you will get a domain with this .pythonanywhere.com. okay, and there are some restrictions. You will exactly get a free account for your testing purposes, and exactly you can use this stuff for your 512 MB exactly you can get for your file storage, and with this file storage exactly you can run some simple strategies. Okay, and you can run your task, whatever automate task, okay, at from starting point to the ending point for a day, for a daily task. You can carry a task for this in this one. Okay, I have been exactly like tested this one. Okay, for simple strategies it will be like good and exactly for free. And if you want to move for per month for $5 per month is there, so you can calculate in INR also how much it will be like for this one. Okay, so I'm little bit happy because I can run my simple strategies and I can automate my stuffs. Okay, and if you want to switch on, you can switch on and you can do all those stuffs. So as a beginning point, as I can say, you can use this stuffs. Okay, so I just say, so I'm gonna show you right now how you can simple strategy is there. If you written some simple codes in Python and exactly want to deploy and want to run those stuffs, how you should make use of this. As my previous video I've been explained about this pip install virtual nv. Exactly I've been installed in this Windows. Now exactly I'm gonna do in this Linux. Okay, so the process is I will create a folder, then exactly I will install interpreter. I will be using Python 3.6. okay, I'm working on it. Okay, and other stuffs, there are Python 2.7 is also there for which you can use. You can use it to console in this one and can make use of these things. So exactly I'm gonna show you how exactly you can make use of these things. Okay, from beginning, so you should follow this carefully. You should follow these steps very much carefully. Okay, so I will land up to this bash console, say Linux, this one terminal. Okay, so as you can see, so now what I'm gonna do is first I will make a directory for it. Okay, so I'm just gonna say that I need a directory. So what I say, I will say that I will make a directory as a profit data. I will make a directory in this one, and after making directory I will land up to this one. Okay, where exactly I want my installation to be get done. Okay, so now how I'm gonna use, first of all, pip is there. Okay, but what I'm gonna do is I should install this virtual environment. Okay, first of all I need virtual environment, then exactly I'll go with this installation of Kite Connect. So what I will say is pip install virtual env. okay, so exactly I'm installing. Okay, so as you see this the requirement has been already satisfied. Okay, I think it's in 2.7 or something. Okay, so first I will go with this Python installation. Okay, so pip is already there. So now what I need is my Python 3.6 have this virtual env, and exactly I can work on this stuff. Okay, so I will say make virtual env, and I should name a folder where exactly I want each and everything should be get done. A main folder, then subfolder. So what my subfolder will be kite 3, okay, and what I will say my python you know, I need python 3.6 interpreter, okay. So I will say this python 3.6 I need, okay. So I'm gonna use this one, okay. So as you see these things, exactly, you know, I'm making use of this kite 3. I am in machine, I'm installing this python 3.6 interpreter for this kite 3 folder, where exactly I'm making this virtual env, okay. So as you can see, everything I've been got, my virtual env wrapper, each and everything I've been got, and I got python 3.6 also, okay. So next, what I'm gonna I have to work on this. If you run your kite 3 program, like, you know, if you go with the dashboard and other console files, it won't work. But you have to follow these procedures to work on this, and exactly you have to run all those tools from your bash console itself, okay. So work on what I need to work on is like on kite 3 exactly I want to work on, okay. So in this kite 3, what I need to do is, like, I got kite 3 folder and you know, each and everything. Now what I need is, like, I should install this Kite Connect. So you already know that, you know, Kite Connect has been upgraded with this Kite Connect 3.0. So I'm gonna this is exactly installation part which I already shown you in the previous video. So you should follow this steps. Okay. So as you can see, previously if I try with this console also, if you directly install it, won't get installed because some distros, some packages will definitely gonna give errors to you. So basic this, if you follow this one, exactly your installation will get complete and you have no errors and other stuff will get in your way, okay. So as you can see, my installation has been going on, and I've been already done all this work, but for you people, I'm just showing all these things, how you can perform all this stuff, and can simple strategies you can, like, you know, go with the price action or any kind of strategies which you want to automate, and, like, you know, without any hassle fee, if you want to, like, keep in background or something and just want to run and just forget it, this, then you can use this stuff, you can have it, but at limited certain of things. And if you want to, like, go for other things, you can go. One thing I tell you, I'm not getting anything from, like, whatever I'm, like, doing for these things. For your purpose, I'm doing this one, so you can follow the steps and can have it by your steps, okay. So I'm just showing you exactly. So my installation part is done, okay. So I've been, like, got cleaned out each and everything, I've been got whatever I required. Now exactly I will move to the coding part. So what I gonna show is, like, first of all, I will clear it, each and everything I will clear it, okay. So I've been cleared it, and next I'm gonna do is, like, I will go with this nano and this kite3.py. I named it my file as a kite3.py, okay. So this kite3.py is okay, but what I need is, like, as you know already, I need API key and API secret and access token, okay, which I have been already done, okay. So what I'm gonna do is, like, I'll go with my dashboard, okay, and exactly from my computer, exactly I've been first of all, like, in this before this, I just close this stuff and I'm gonna show you. If you, like, came with the dashboard, and exactly if you come this one, if you want to come with this, exactly as you can see, already things has been not evaporated, it is already there. So I will say nano kite 3.9.py, okay. So I will say from kite connect import kite connect. So as you know, this is my library, okay, and in previous also I've shown you how exactly if you run, exactly if your running this, and if you are getting this hello world, then exactly it means you are getting this program, means Kite Connect has been installed, Kite Connect 3.0 has been installed. Okay, if you want to save this one, you try to exit and it will ask whether you want to save or not. Say why and then enter. And then exactly if you reach this stuff, say I will clear this stuff. Okay, sorry. Okay, and I will say that I want to been installed, and then I will say Python kite 3.py. If I say this stuff, then exactly it will print me as a hello world. If I got this one, then definitely my installation has been completed. I have no need to worry about. Now exactly I'm gonna show you, as I have been talked about this Kite Connect docs, as you see this one. Okay, if you get to know about this Kite Connect docs is there, if you talk about this stuff from this point of view, exactly you get to know that so many things has been changed. And if you refer this Kite Connect docs, Kite Connect module is there, so many things has been changed, and you should follow these steps for for your order placement and anything. If you want to do, you can do these steps. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is, like, now I need API key, API secret and access token. Okay, so first of all I need to I will close this one, I will exit and come once again for this one. Okay, so I'm just gonna I will go in this one and I will look for files in this one. First of all I will look for the files. Okay, so I will, if you see this one, profit data is there. Okay, and kite 3.py is also there. Okay, now what I need is, like, as I already said, so I will just go away straight. I've been saved my API key, API secret and access token to this text folder. So I will upload this files to this one for my profit data folder, and each and everything I will just API secret and exactly access token. I'm just in real itself, I'm just gonna show you how you can have all those stuff. Okay, so I've been already saved this one. Okay, so you can work on this text editor file also. There will be won't be any problem. But the thing, if you want to run this file, then exactly you have to use your Kite Bash console. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is, like, I need to call my API key. So I will say API key equals open my API key, and I will say API underscore key dot txt, and I have to read this stuff, so I'm gonna say straight away read this one. Okay, which I've been already done all this stuff, so you should follow this one and can have. Okay, now what I'm gonna do is, like, I should read this API secret. Okay, and then I will say open API secret dot txt. And I'm gonna read this. Okay, now what I have to do is, like, first of all I have to say that whatever my kite is there, it should be universal use. Okay, so I will say API underscore key equals API key. Okay, now what I will say, I should make error. Now I have to set my access token. Okay, so I will say that kite dot set underscore access token, and I need to open my access token dot txt, which have been already saved. I'm gonna do is, like, I'm just gonna show you in this Kite Connect module.